Ease raised to the third power. Video 3, prep before class.
Do you attend class without knowing the topics to be discussed? Do you usually read your textbook after lecture instead of before lecture? Do you set aside 1 or 2 days per week to study for hours at a time? If you have answered yes to any of these questions, then this video is for you.
Brain rule. See it, hear it, think it again and again. Repetition is good for learning. The more you see, read, hear, write about a topic, the more you will be familiar and remember that topic. As you become more familiar, your brain will process faster, and you will have a stronger understanding and retrieval of information. When your brain understands the info, you will be less confused, not like you're losing your mind. Brain rule. The first time you see or hear new info, it will take you the longest to learn. Lecture should not be the first time you hear or see the topic. To prevent overwhelming the brain during lecture, become familiar with the topic before lecture. Applying this to the classroom means you must first prepare for lecture by reading before coming to lecture. Do not expect to understand everything before lecture. The goal is to be familiar with the topics before lecture so you can keep up with lecture instead of being confused or overwhelmed. Learning stops when you are overwhelmed. You do not want your brain to shut down when you are in lecture because you will miss out on important information given. Getting familiar with a topic. There are many ways to become familiar with a topic. 1. If you have the PowerPoint slides, then read the slides before coming to class. 2. Follow the syllabus and read the chapter before lecture. Use the technique taught in video 2 to read in layers to save time and gain an overview of the topic. Brain rule. If you prepare before lecture, you will get the most from lecture. 2 types of learning. Preparing before lecture will benefit you in several ways. To understand, you must know that we switch between 2 types of learning, focus and diffuse. Brain rule. Focused learning happens when we are actively concentrating, like studying before lecture. Brain rule. Diffuse learning includes making connections between the new topic with existing info or seeing the topic in a different perspective. It is the aha moment when we finally understand. This may happen in lecture or during a break. Brain rule. It is important to take breaks for diffuse learning to happen. Physical activities are ideal because they will increase your heart and breathing rates to deliver more oxygen to your brain. Physical activities, especially chores, are great choices for breaks. It is better to take short breaks in between short study spurts instead of long breaks after hours of studying. Physical activities can also be eating or drinking something nutritious, low fat, low sugar, and low salt, if you are hungry or thirsty. Work with your brain, not against it. If you are tired, then your brain is tired. So sleep, nap, or do physical activities. Forcing your brain to learn when it is tired is wasting your time. Sleep is extremely important for your brain. A well-rested student can learn faster and easier. A well-rested brain can recall info faster and make fewer mistakes than a sleepy brain. Brain rule. Sleep helps your memory. During sleep, info is moved from short-term to long-term memory. Added bonus, the brain is also cleansed of toxicity when you sleep. Brain rule. Anytime you lose focus, start to daydream, or wander away from the topic, you need a short break. Of course, breaks should never be longer than your study times. On your breaks, do something completely different from studying. Do not do activities that are similar to studying, like reading a novel or listening to lecture. For most, it is easier and faster to learn new info in short spurts of a few minutes while you can still focus. If you can focus for a long time, then you can study longer. It is better to study a little daily rather than batch it into only one day or 2 days per week for several hours. You have to focus to pay attention to learn. So study in a place with minimal distractions if you want to learn fast. Emotions may be distracting, so it is best to study when you are emotionally stable, not upset, anxious, etc. Now that you know when and where to study, as well as when and what to do for breaks, let's continue to video 4, getting the most from lecture.